Morning Summit, I'm Jake, and you know this guy. Just kidding, trying to do my best Edward Crouch impersonation. He's not here today. I'll have some information on that in just a second, but this is your weekly update. And so before I make our announcements for the week, share this video on all of your platforms, Twitter, Facebook, email your small group. Got some important announcements coming up, okay? And so we want to get the word out. Now, this Sunday, one service at 10 a.m. Everybody repeat after me. One service, 10 a.m. All right? So if you show up at 9, we're going to put you to work. If you show up at 11, you're probably going to be walking in at the end of the service. And so we don't want you to miss that. So make sure you get the word out. Help us spread the news. We've been talking about this for about 5 weeks now. One service, 10 a.m. It starts this Sunday. Also, after the 10 a.m. service at around 11:30-ish, we're going to be offering membership. And so if you have been thinking about taking membership, please email me at jake@summitheightsfellowship.com or come up to me either before or after the service and we can get you registered for that class. You really don't even need to register. Just let us know that you want to be a part of learning more about Summit Heights and we'd love to be able to get you connected, okay? And on May the 2nd, which is a week from Sunday, we're going to have Curtis Grimes and his band leading us in worship. Ashley and our preteens are going to be doing the baked potato sale on that day as well. And so come expecting on May 2nd, come hungry, make sure that you support those preteens. Also, David Bright and our youth ministry team, this Sunday, next Sunday, connect with him. He's got some t-shirts, some really cool t-shirts that he is selling. Youth ministry is trying to raise their money to go to camp as well, and so connect with him. I'm actually going to be wearing one of the t-shirts this Sunday so you can see what they look like, all right? And it's going to be a cool deal. Now, I need to kind of circle back to something that we kind of mentioned last week, and I got some emails about it and just people wanting to get clarity on the red stickers and the signs for social distancing. So, you know, we're going to one service, and so the auditorium is going to be full, we hope, and so some of you are still wanting to social distance, and so we at Summit Heights, we're big on relationship. We love God and we love people and we're big huggers and high fivers and all that stuff. And some of you are still social distancing. And so we're going to have a table set up with some stickers and these little signed cards. Now, I have demonstrated today what this is going to look like. So I did not want to be around Edward today. I just didn't. So I put my red sticker on, and I got my little reserved for social distancing card. I set it next to the chair that he normally sits in, and what I am telling Edward is, I don't want you around me. It's that simple, okay? I just don't, all right? And so that's how that's going to work. I'm just kidding, y'all. I really do love Edward, and we know that you love people. This is not a system for us to isolate. This is simply a way for if you want the seat next to you to be reserved for social distancing, we're going to have a table in the front. We're going to have a table in the back. Just pick up a card, place it in that seat, put a sticker right here, and that way people know that you want a social distance, okay? There's no, like, cootie scenario. Like, we're not trying to be like, stay away from me. We want to honor the people that want to social distance, okay? Now, if you're like me and you want to just hug everybody that you see and you see somebody wearing a red sticker, just give them a thumbs up, give them a what up dog, maybe an elbow, something like that, and go about your way. So anyway, that's how that's going to work, okay? We're excited, man. We're excited. I hope Edward didn't get his feelings hurt today. He actually called me on Tuesday, and he said, man, I really want to be in the video. And I said, no, can't do it, man. Got to stay away from you. Social distancing from Edward. I'm not a big social distancer, but from Edward, I can make that work, all right? So anyway, hopefully I'll let him back on next week, all right? So with that being said, I'm excited about this Sunday. We're going to be talking about something that God has put on my heart about a year ago, And man, I just don't feel like God's released me from this message yet. And so we're going to be talking more about that message. It's going to align with the series that we've been doing on trust. And so I thought Edward knocked it out of the park last week, really spoke to me. And so, man, we hope to see everybody there. If you can't make it in person, don't forget, we're online, Facebook Live, YouTube Live, and on our website. So with all that being said, I think I need to make a phone call and apologize to Edward for the way I treated him today. And so I'm going to go. But man, we hope to see you Sunday. God bless.